today's I mean whatever we had discussed yesterday, and please open menti.com. Yes. Who is this? Hello.
Open, sir.
Oh, okay, very good. In a moment, I'm sharing with you my first question. You must grant permission in order to share the screen. Excuse me.
Yes, sir.
Sorry for the inconvenience. Yes, some technical problem was there. By the way, this is basically the first question I'm posing to you. See, first of all, you need to go to menti.com. And this is a 6 to 7 digit code. Okay. You need to enter. And this is your question. And I expect each of you to, answer this question in your way. Okay. Please go ahead. Your time will be for only 10 to 15 seconds. Hurry up. The time is already started. Okay, done. So, still few more students are left. Is one in which the outer surface is in direct contact with the cooling water jacket. Okay. Fine. Now, my concern about these 2% boys, whoever, only one student have answer as a dry. Effort is required on his side, otherwise out of 56 students have answered correctly. Okay, so it's really very great. After this, there will be another question. And if you have gone through the content yesterday, then you will be able to answer it. Okay, and before starting this discussion for today, I would like to all of you to answer this question also. This question is about the desirable properties of the material. Okay, so here is the second question for you. Okay, so get ready for the same. Okay, this time the code is 7023799, and whatever desirable properties you remember about the cylinder liner, you need to answer that. Don't worry. Yeah, these are the different ways of motivation. At least he's typing. Whoever is copying, at least, you know, bothering to typing. Okay. Anyway, I have different ideas for the next lectures. Don't worry about that. Okay, so we shall stop here. Okay, so there are various answers. Someone has written that it should be hard enough. It should withstand thermal stresses and highly corrosive resistant. Okay, very good. And someone is saying the desirable properties of the material are as follows. ये तो भाई किसी ने copy मारा है. Okay, nahi, but it is good. I must appreciate the way you all have written the answers. Good surface finish to reduce friction, to withstand high gas pressure. It should sustain high gas pressure, high thermal conductivity. Very good. So this way we got a total 47 responses, and out of 65 students, only 47 responses. So this is something which is basically which require little bit consideration, because most of we have, I mean, you know, almost more than 20% people have, more than 20-30% have not responded to this question. It should be strong enough, hardenability, toughness, high strength. It should withstand gas pressure, etc., etc. Anyway, so this were a few properties you should have remember. The material should be strong enough to withstand high gas pressure. It should be strong enough to withstand thermal stresses. It should be hard to resist wear. It should be corrosion resistant, and it should have good surface finish. So these are a few desirable properties you expect from the material material to be selected for the cylinder liner. ठीक है, so let's go ahead. By the way, how was this idea?
Very good, sir.
Good. So yesterday we stopped at this particular discussion. Okay, yes, so we sir, got yes, to know. Haji, any question someone is asking?
No, sir.
No, no. Okay, so this is the point where we stopped yesterday, and this way we got to know that there are two types of stresses, called as apparent stress and the net stress. So the apparent stress is the stress which is basically induced in the cylinder because of the gas pressure, whereas when the Poisson ratio is considered, depending upon the lateral strain and the linear strain, we basically are able to find out the circumferential strength net as equal to sigma c minus mu times sigma l, whereas longitudinal stress net is equal to sigma l minus mu times sigma c. Okay, so after this, let's go ahead and see. These are a few empirical relations. Sometime when the desirable, when the properties of the material is given in the form of ultimate distance, factor of safety, and the gas pressure, etc., you can find out directly by the strength relation. Otherwise, sometime we can also use this empirical relation in order to find out the dimension. For example, if you need to find out the thickness of the cylinder wall, it could be determined by this empirical relation, such as 0.045 d plus 1.6 millimeter. Okay, where d is the diameter of cylinder. So for example, if the diameter of cylinder is coming out to be 75 millimeter, then 0.045 need to be multiplied plus 1.6 millimeter. So this empirical relation is going to give you the thickness of the cylinder. Okay, general formula. Then it also gives you idea about the range of the thickness. The thickness of for the dry liner should be equal to 0.03 d to 0.035 d. This is the relation. Then thickness of the water jacket. Okay, water jacket wall. Okay, this must be 1/3 to 3/4 of the thickness. Okay, or it could be 0.032 d plus 1.6 millimeter. Also, when you need to find out the space, water space. What do I mean? See, in the figure we have seen that this water space is basically provided where we basically use the coolant. So this, the thickness of this water space should be equal to 9 millimeter, okay, to 75 millimeter for a bore size of 75 millimeter to 750 millimeter. So this basically vary. This water space basically vary depending upon the size of the cylinder. So for example, if the cylinder diameter is 75 millimeter, so minimum water space should be 9 millimeter. Okay, and this way there is basically a range. Okay, for example, for 80 millimeter, it must be around 10 millimeter, 10.5 millimeter. This way, it goes up to 750 millimeter, where in which you have the maximum water space available to be 75 millimeter. Okay, so all this information is available in the data book. You don't have to worry about this. But there is an approach. Okay, as we have learned in machine design, that apart from strength equation, we can also use this empirical relation to determine the dimensions. Right. Now next. The next important component is the design of the cylinder head. See, cylinder head which we saw yesterday in the animation, this was very complex piece because there were a lot of, apart from it is having, a particular width, particular length and particular height, there were many shapes available in order to accommodate combustion chamber. There were many holes to accommodate inlet wall, exhaust wall, a location for the fuel injector and the spark plug, etc. Okay, designing such a complex will be difficult here. That is why what we do, we basically assume this entire cylinder head as a simple rectangular piece, wherein our basic aim will be to determine the thickness. What do I mean? I mean that, for example, I may be having this as my overall, okay, dimensions, okay, wherein I may be having different holes, okay, so volume for some space provided for the combustion chamber, etc., etc. But here I'm not bothering about all those features. I just want to determine the thickness of this. Okay. Why thickness only? Because thickness should be sufficient enough in order to bear the combustion pressure. That is why we find out the thickness of the cylinder head by this empirical formula. TH is equal to D times under root of K, a constant, times P max by sigma C, which is basically the allowable circumferential stress. Okay, so I have here K, the value of constant for the design of cylinder head as 0.162. you need to remember this value, otherwise this information is already in the book. So the thickness th, which is determined in millimeter, should be equal to d times, okay, under root of k times p max by sigma c. Mind you, these two units will be cancelled. I'm saying unit, not dimension. This unit will be cancelled in terms of megapascal and megapascal. Okay, this constant having no unit, that is why this diameter in millimeter will give you millimeter. Okay, so this way, th is equal to d times under root of k times p max by sigma c is the formula to determine the thickness. Okay, now the material of the cylinder head is also considered to be brittle, like for example cast iron. Okay, so in that case you need to select the, depending upon FG 250 or FG 200, etc., you need to find select this ultimate strength. Okay, assume some factor of safety, then you can determine the circumferential stress. Okay, P max can be easily found, as I said yesterday, that if it is not directly given, you can take P max as 10 times of P mean. Okay, mean effective pressure. Then if you need to find out the sigma c by empirical relation, so for cylinder head, mind you, for the cylinder liner it was between 35 to 100 or 30 to 100 megapascal. For cylinder head, okay, if the ultimate strength, the value is not given, you can directly assume some with this value somewhere between 30 to 50 megapascal. Okay, so this particular equation will give you the dimension th. Okay, next. Is it okay, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. After determining the thickness of the cylinder head, we need to determine the number of studs, because we need to form the assembly of the head and the block with the help of a stud only. So how do we find the number of studs? So first of all, what we do, we determine the number of studs. Okay. We cannot arrive directly at a fixed number of bolts. So what we need to do is, we need to determine the range of the studs, some minimum value to some maximum value. So this empirical relation basically gives you idea about minimum number of studs, which says that the minimum number of studs should be 0.01 times d plus 4. Okay, iska matlab ye malum pada ki kam se kam 4 bolt to hone chahiye. Why 4 bolts? Because, okay, even if you are considering one cylinder, single cylinder engine, then in a single cylinder engine you must have one bolt here, third bolt here, and fourth bolt here. Okay, so irrespective of the size of the cylinder, at least there must be 4 bolts. But as the size of the cylinder increases, okay, the size of cylinder changes, you need to increase the number of studs. That is why you have the minimum number of studs determined by 0.01 d plus 4, and the maximum number of studs can be determined from this formula, 0.02 d plus 4. Okay, so this is one. After determining the number of studs, okay, we need to understand how to determine the size of the bolt. Okay, as you know that whatever gas pressure is induced, this gas pressure is going to be resisted by the number of studs. That is why, okay, we have for example here, for example, for example, the maximum gas pressure is P max into pi by 4 B square. This is nothing but the total bursting force induced because of the combustion of gas, because of the combustion of fuel. Okay, but this bursting force must be resisted by N number or Z number of bolts. Okay, so you have Z into pi by 4 dc square, okay, the area multiplied by sigma t. So this is the area of one bolt multiplied by the tensile strength. So this is going to give you force resisted by one bolt. So force resisted by one bolt multiplied by the number of bolt will be equal to the total bursting force. So that is basically given by this particular equation. Okay, then as usually you know that once the core diameter is found from this relation, you will be able to find out the nominal size by the standard table or by this Ampel-Likert relation, as the nominal size is equal to PC by 0.84 or 0.8. Okay, so this is one. So what we do, after determining the thickness of the cylinder head, we find out the number of studs from this relation, and we find out the size of stud by this equation, where I'm equating the total gas force, the total bursting force, by the resistance force offered by the bolt. Okay, now once this is determined, there are some extra calculations, there are some extra considerations given. Although this particular idea will not be applicable to a rectangular cylinder head. This is not going to be applicable to a rectangular cylinder head because it is talking about pitch, okay, minimum pitch circle, maximum pitch, etc., etc. But here, see, because pi dp, etc. are given. So that means this particular concept, this particular information is mainly related to the circular cylinder head, circular shape of cylinder head. Okay. So, just to have idea, if you need to find out the pitch circle diameter of a circular flange, which is used in a single cylinder engine, for example, as a circular cylinder head, then there the pitch circle diameter can be taken as D plus 3 times D, where D is the nominal size of the bolt or nominal size of the stud. Then minimum pitch and maximum pitch, what it is basically referring is this. The angular gap between the two bolts, for example, if you are having this as a circular flange, okay, and if this is, then if you are inserting, if you are placing one bolt here, then another bolt, another stud must be here. So this is basically the angular placement, okay. So the pitch of the stud should be given by this particular information by as pi dp over Z. Okay, so depending upon the circumference of the pitch circle diameter and the number of studs to be incorporated, you can find out the pitch of the stud in circular flange, in circular cylinder head. Okay, next. Is this okay now?
Yes, sir.
Please respond me, guys.
Once again.
Who is this? Nakwa.
Sir Zafar.
Are acha Hashmi sir, wow, 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 kya baat hai. Okay, so let me repeat as is demanded, as is requested by Zafar. So let me repeat once again. Which part, Zafar, you want me to explain again?
Sir, a pitch of studs.
Pitch of the stud. See what I am saying. See, in this book particularly. See, actually, अभी किसी cylinder में इस प्रकार का cylinder head नहीं होता, हाँ, circular नहीं होता ना? ये बात तो clear है? है क्या नहीं?
Yes.
हाँ. So what this book is, what this information is about, you know, that whenever suppose there is a single cylinder engine in which, for example, bike. Okay, if you want to have a circular cylinder head, in that case, whatever number of bolts are required, that can be determined. Whatever number of bolts are to be placed, whatever number of studs are to be placed, that can be determined by the size of the pitch circle diameter and this information. That is basically the idea. Okay, so if you need to find out the pitch circle diameter, that is the diameter here. Okay, so let's say this is basically the pitch circle diameter dp. dp malum hone ke baad, abhi what about this outer diameter? Someone must also be thinking ki ye diameter kaise malum karenge? Is diameter, ye diameter malum karne ke liye mujhe pitch diameter to pata chal chuka hai, mujhe ye jo extra jo thickness maine jo liya hai yahan par dono taraf, yahan par aur yahan par, इसको बोलते हैं मार्जिन, मतलब मार्जिन इनफैक्ट इज वॉट, मार्जिन इज बेसिकली दिस स्पेस. ओके, मार्जिन शुड बी सफिशियंट, एक्चुअली इट इज नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट मार्जिन हियर, बट मार्जिन शुड बी सफिशियंटली मोर देन हाफ द डायमीटर, सो दैट अगर ये ज्यादा क्लोज हो गया तो ये मटेरियल को यहां से टेयर कर देगा, ठीक है, ये मटेरियल को यहां से फाड़ देगा, एंड योर डिजाइन विल बी फेलिंग. सो आफ्टर द पिच सर्कल डायमीटर, आपने यहां पर हाफ डी लिया, हाफ डी लिया डायमीटर ऑफ स्टड, एंड दिस मस्ट, देयर मस्ट बी सफिशियंट स्पेस हियर सो दैट द टेयरिंग इज प्रिवेंटेड. ओके, ये हो गया. उसके बाद यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट कि मिनिमम कितना पिच होना चाहिए, मैक्सिमम पिच कितना होना चाहिए. अब ये इन्फॉर्मेशन क्यों चाहिए, बिकॉज अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस रेडियल थिकनेस, दो बोल्ट के बीच में भी सफिशियंट स्पेस होना चाहिए, दो स्टड के बीच में भी सफिशियंट स्पेस होना चाहिए. इफ दे आर टू फार क्वाइट इफ दे आर टू फार क्वाइट पॉसिबली द गैस मे लीक, ओके, फ्रॉम दिस स्पेस. वेर एज ऑन द कॉन्ट्ररी, इफ दिस टू बोल्ट, इफ दिस टू इट्स आर वेरी क्लोज, सो द स्पेस बिटवीन देम विल ऑल्सो बी, okay, will be torn, so this will be again a problem. That is why the idea of determining the minimum pitch and maximum pitch is this. Okay, so you have to play between these two, and you need to optimize this in order to accommodate the given number of studs. Okay.
Okay, sir.
ठीक है, चलो हम लोग आगे चलते हैं. I hope that everyone is carrying today calculator and
sir margin kitna hota hai,
notebook
kitna hona chahiye.
Ha ji, ha
sir, wo margin bataya na, radius radius ka half hona chahiye.
Ha, ye at least jo diameter jo hai na, diameter ka half se utna kam se kam hona chahiye, ya to thoda usse zyada hona chahiye, usse kam hoga. Acha, ye bhi jo actual jo relation hai, main aapko data book mein se dekh ke batata hu. But my idea is what, it should not be less or it should not be too much. अगर बहुत ज्यादा होगा तो भी प्रॉब्लम है. ओके, बिकॉज इट इज जस्ट अ वेस्टेज ऑफ मटेरियल. ओके, ये जो स्पेस है, ये वाला जो मार्जिन है, अगर बहुत कम हुआ तो मटेरियल यहाँ से फेल हो जाएगा. ओके, इट विल फेल, एंड इफ इट इज टू मच इट विल बी ऑफ नो यूज. ओके, दैट इज वाई यहाँ पर आपको ओआर का फंडा यूज करना पड़ेगा, ऑपरेशन रिसर्च ऑप्टिमाइजेशन का, और आपको इसकी साइज डिटरमाइन करनी पड़ेगी. सो दिस स्पेस, ये एक्चुअली ये वही है, ये मिनिमाइजेशन एंड मैक्सिमाइजेशन, ये ऑप्टिमाइजेशन का ही फंडा है.
सर, हेलो सर.
हाँ जी, हु इज दिस?
सर सादिक.
सादिक, हाँ बोलो.
सर, ये नंबर ऑफ स्टड्स किस बेसिस पे डिटरमाइन करते हैं अपन?
आई टोल्ड यू ना, द नंबर ऑफ बोल्ट इज बेसिकली डिटरमाइंड बाय द साइज ऑफ द सिलेंडर.
ओके ओके सर.
सी सी, इट इज द साइज ऑफ द सिलेंडर. ठीक है, लेकिन इतना पक्का है कि आपका सिलेंडर चाहे 62 मिलीमीटर का हो या फिर 75 मिलीमीटर का हो, ये तो पक्का है कि भाई जैसे जैसे साइज बढ़ेगा वैसे वैसे नंबर ऑफ स्टड्स बढ़ेंगे, लेकिन कम से कम 4 बोल्ट होने ही चाहिए. दैट इज व्हाई द कांस्टेंट इज 4. कम से कम 4 होने चाहिए. इस क्वेश्चन को, इस पॉइंट को याद करके रखो कि भाई कम से कम 4 तो होने ही चाहिए. इवन इफ इट इज अ रेक्टेंगुलर और अ स्क्वायर फ्लैंज, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, ऐसा भी हो सकता है कि मेरी जो बाइक है, बाइक में आई एम हैविंग दिस काइंड ऑफ अ फ्लैंज, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, जो मेरा ये है, सपोज ये स्क्वायर शेप का ऐसा कुछ है. ठीक है, सो हियर आई एम गोइंग टू हैव 1, 2, 3 एंड 4 नंबर ऑफ, अगर साइज बढ़ गया फॉर एग्जांपल, सो आई मे हैव हियर, ओके, थोड़ा सा अभी इसका ये ऊपर टॉप का भी शेप चेंज हो सकता है. इंस्टेड ऑफ गोइंग फॉर द स्क्वायर, आई मे गो फॉर सर्कुलर शेप, करेक्ट ना? बिकॉज अगर यहाँ पर 6 नंबर ऑफ अगर लगते हैं तो 6, दिस काइंड ऑफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन विल नॉट बी ओके. व्हाई? क्योंकि यहाँ पर तो ठीक है, लेकिन गैस का यहाँ से प्रॉब्लम है, यहाँ से लीक होने के चांसेस है ना? सो दैट इज व्हाई आई मे चेंज द शेप ऑल्सो. आई मे, इंस्टेड ऑफ प्रोवाइडिंग दिस स्क्वायर और द रेक्टेंगुलर, आई मे प्रोवाइड सर्कुलर शेप, सो दैट आई कैन अकोमोडेट, ओके, यूनिफॉर्मली. ओके.
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now please take down one question. ओके डियर स्टूडेंट्स काय तरी काय लिहिलं आहे वेट काय नाही साहित्य आधी सही तरी विचार फाइन सो आगे जाने से पहले मुनीबा सबा इरम
यस सर
एवरीवन इज अंडरस्टैंडिंग
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, very good. Okay, okay, very good. Amir Khan hai ki Amir Khan? Ammar? Anas?
Yes, sir.
Basit Patel from Nashik? Kev Patel also from Nashik?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Moin, Muniba. Omkar Patil.
Sir.
Arey, yes, I haven't shared with you a good news that this time Omkar Patil is the captain of PAHA 2021.
Thank you, sir.
Congrats, Omkar.
Congrats, bro.
Thank you.
Okay, very good. Where is Hardik Poddar?
Yes, sir.
Okay. How about you? Are you understanding everything?
What, sir?
Are you understanding whatever I'm explaining?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Fine. So, let's take a simple question. This question is from Bhandari. Okay, I hope you will be able to solve this example. See, the information given here is the cylinder of a four-stroke diesel engine has the following specification. Okay, it is having brake power. Brake power 3.75 kilowatt. Speed n is this is BP brake power. The speed is n. The indicated mean effective pressure. Indicated mean effective pressure is 0.35 megapascal. Okay. Mechanical efficiency is 80%, and two important dimensions need to be found out here initially, because this is the first example. You know, just in order to start with, we need to find out the bore, and we need to find out the length of cylinder. Okay, छोटा सा तुच्छ सा प्रश्न. Bore मतलब क्या bore? What is meant by bore here? D ना?
So diameter of the cylinder.
Diameter D.
What is mean by length of cylinder?
Trunk.
What is the length of cylinder?
Trunk. 0.15 length of the stroke.
Iram?
Stroke.
What
do you say? Stroke.
Is it small L or capital L?
Capital L.
Is it this?
Capital L.
Sir, capital L.
Small L is length of the stroke, capital L is the length of the cylinder.
Barabar, barabar.
Yes, 2L is right.
Chalo, no problem. So let's start. This example, If you look at this part, mechanical efficiency is given, brake power is given, okay, and we know that mechanical efficiency eta is dp upon ip, okay. Therefore, you have ip is dp over eta. Dp is given as 3.75 kilowatt divided by 0.8. So what you are going to find is ip. IP should be calculated in terms of kilowatt. Tell me how much it is.
4.6.
What is the answer, gentlemen? 4.6.
Yes, sir.
Excuse me.
Anybody? Yes, sir.
Motion box?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. 4.68 kilowatt.
So 4.68 kilowatt.
Yeah, very good. Bilal, this is 4.6. Yeah, Bilal is answering, it is
4.6875 kilowatt.
4.6875 kilowatt. You convert this into watt multiplying with 1000. Okay. So you are going to get the answer as 4687.5 watts. Okay. So we get indicated power to be 4687.5 watts. Okay. Step number one. Now step number two. We also know that the indicated power is given by Pm times L into A into N, not N, it is a small n, okay, divided by 60, okay, because it is a four-stroke diesel engine, N should be?
N by 2.
Yeah, very good. You have where L is the length of a stroke, okay, A is the area of cylinder, where area of cylinder is given by pi by 4 d square, so where d is the diameter of cylinder, okay, this is the diameter of cylinder. Okay. Also, we need to remember one important thing, that this IP which we have got, it is in terms of watt. Watt is nothing but joules per second. Joule per second is nothing but Newton meter per second. So we need to convert one of the dimension into meter. That is why what I'm going to do is, I'm going to basically substitute one of the dimension into meter, So see how, something like this. Let me also write down about n as number of working strokes, which is equal to n by 2. Okay. Also, assuming L by D ratio as 1.5, the normal range is between 1.25 to, I'm assuming 1.5 the range. Okay, I mean the ratio of L by D. Therefore, I have L is equal to 1.5 times D. Okay, so D I'm converting into meter. So I'm going to have 1.5 times D divided by, because ye millimeter mein tha, isko meter mein convert karne ke liye 1000 se divide karna padega. Okay. इतना ठीक है?
Yes sir.
Sir, yes, sir.
Sorry.
बॉटम हिड हाइड हो रहा है सर नीचे का.
Okay, so I got all the information now. I'm going to substitute in this equation. So I have 4. Four, six, eight, 7.5 is equal to, you had 0.35 indicated pressure. Length of L is 1.5 times D divided by 1000. This is L. Area is coming out to be pi by 4 D square into, you have 500 divided by 60. Okay. So from this relation, you are going to get D ka value. Tell me what is D?
Point 88 meter.
It is millimeter.
How much?
880 mm, sir.
880?
Yes, sir. Mm.
No. You carefully calculate.
So 110.90.
Ahmed, kitna aaya, sir?
Hello. 110 aaya, sir.
Sir, 110.90.
Okay. 110.90. Okay. Correct. So D It's coming out to be 110.9.
हेलो अरे सर मैं जॉइन करना लवकर फटफट रजिस्टर करा था
ओके सो आवर आंसर इज 110.9
90.
Yes. Now, if you go for the bore diameter from this table, you will come to know that 110.9 is not available. See, if you look at this part, if you look at this information, like in the data, you will find that after 110, it is 115 directly. ठीक है. So, if you are strictly going by the data book, then after 110, it should be 115 as the size. Agree?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
एक तो ये approach हो गया. एक तो ये approach हो गया. Second approach is, if you go by approximation, then instead of 115, you can select 110.9 के बाद directly 112. You cannot go for 111. Because जितना even figure हो diameter वगैरह के size case में तो it is good. That is why instead of selecting 115, okay, as per this standard, as per this reference, you can select 112. ठीक है, लेकिन अभी हम लोग एक काम करते हैं, हम लोग यहाँ से standard book का reference देते हैं, and we are saying हम लोग बोलते हैं from standard table. From standard data book, we select D is equal to 115 millimeter. Okay.
Sure.
Aji.
Sir, हम लोग उसमें से next वाले higher value लेना चाहिए क्या? हम लोग 110 नहीं ले सकते?
नहीं ना, अभी अभी ये तो फंडामेंटल है फॉर्म का यार. हम लोग ने देखा कि जो मिनिमम साइज 110.9 है, तो हाउ कैन वी गो अबाउट 110? वी को फेल हो जाएगा वहां पर आके ना.
ओके ओके सर.
ठीक है, सो आफ्टर फाइंडिंग 115 एज अ डायमीटर, नाउ लेट्स गो अहेड एंड let's find out L as the length of a stroke is 1.5 times of D, so this should be equal to 1.5 times into 115. Please calculate this value.
172.5.
is the length of the stroke. Okay, very good. After finding the length of the stroke, what is the next thing left?
Length of cylinder.
Okay, so we have length of cylinder L. Capital L is equal to 1.15 times of length of stroke. So that is why this should be 1.15 times of 172.5. Just tell me how much it is.
258.75.
Sir, 198.375.
198.375 millimeters. So this way, we are able to find out the length and the diameter.
सर
जी
सर कैन यू स्विच टू द स्लाइड इन विच क्वेश्चन वॉज रिटन ओके सर वॉट इट
हाँ जी ओके 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 लेट्स लुक हियर सी इंडिके सी इन दिस रिलेशन यहां पर इस फॉर्मूले में ओके आई हैव समथिंग व्हाट इज दैट लेट मी एक्सप्लेन सी आई स्टार्टेड माय डिस्कशन विथ सेइंग दैट अलियस गर्ल आई स्टार्टेड माय डिस्कशन सेइंग दैट ये मुझे वैट में चाहिए वैट इज जूल्स पर सेकेंड एंड जूल इज न्यूटन मीटर पर सेकेंड करेक्ट सो नाउ इफ आई वांट टू मेंटेन द इक्विलिब्रियम ऑन बोथ द साइड्स इट मस्ट बी न्यूटन मीटर पर सेकेंड ठीक है सो ये किसमें था प्रेशर किसमें था प्रेशर वॉज इन टर्म्स ऑफ न्यूटन पर मिलीमीटर स्क्वायर मेगा पास्कल ओके इंटू लेंथ ऑफ स्ट्रोक ये किसमें है ये मैंने मीटर में रखा ये मिलीमीटर स्क्वायर में है और ये जो स्पीड है दिस इज पर सेकेंड ओके सो मिलीमीटर मिलीमीटर स्क्वायर गेटिंग कैंसल बट व्हाट आई गेट नाउ न्यूटन मीटर पर सेकेंड सो आई हैव इक्विलिब्रियम मेंटेन नाउ दैट इज व्हाई द लेंथ ऑफ स्ट्रोक नीड टू बी कन्वर्टेड इंटू मीटर बराबर हाँ दैट इज व्हाई वी नीड टू कन्वर्ट इट इनटू मीटर ओके एक छोटा सा असाइनमेंट अभी एक छोटा सा तुम लोग के लिए असाइनमेंट है असाइनमेंट मतलब अभी क्लास में करना है अगर मुझे थिकनेस मालूम करना है इफ आई नीड टू फाइंड आउट द थिकनेस ऑफ द सिलेंडर ओके हाउ शुड आई गो अबाउट
हेलो सर
हाँ जी
सर दिस इज प्रणव
हाँ प्रणव
तो द पास्कल यूनिट इज ऑलवेज न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर नो
नो सर इधर देखो एक मिनट हाँ ये सब तो सिर्फ टीडी में तुम लोग ने सीखा है रे
पास्कल इज न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर एंड मेगा पास्कल इज न्यूटन पर एमएम
स्क्वायर हाँ ना करेक्ट एब्सोल्युटली Because the 10 to 6 hai, idhar dekho. When I'm saying mega pascal, okay, you have mega means 10^6, okay, and pascal is newton per meter square, okay. So you have 10^6 times newton. Now 1000 millimeter, 1 meter is 1000 millimeter. That is why 1000 square is becoming basically newtons per 10^6. हम लोग ने सॉम में एक इक्वेशन डिराइव किया था एक फॉर्मूला इस्टेब्लिश किया था, देयर वी वर अज्यूमिंग दैट 1 मेगा पास्कल इज ऑलवेज इक्वल टू 1 न्यूटन पर एमएम स्क्वायर.
ओके सर. ओके
फाइन. Okay, Zafar is saying it was one of the easiest sum of IC matlab kya IC engine. Zafar Hashmi,
yes.
Okay now after finding the diameter and length of a stroke, let's find out the thickness. Now the thickness P is P max times D divided by 2 into sigma C plus C. This C is called as reboring allowance. Okay. Now suppose I have in this question only D. Okay. C I can take from the data book. Sigma C I need to see like whether what property is given, because ये cast iron है तो cast iron के लिए मुझे sigma C कैसे मिलेगा. If the material is given, for example if it is Fg250, then I have ultimate distance divided by factor of safety calculated. Okay, so मुझे sigma C मिल जाएगा. P max is not given. Okay, had it been given, I would have directly used. Otherwise, I can take P max at 10 times of P min. Okay, so इस प्रकार से अगर मैं ऐसे एक मिक्स अप्रोच भी अगर यूज करता हूँ तो मुझे थिकनेस इजीली मिल सकता है यहाँ पर. ठीक है, तो आई एम एडिंग टू द प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन सम एडिशनल डाटा. टेक डाउन प्लीज. In the previous question, if the cylinder material assumed to be Fg200 or take Fg250, please take down the material of the cylinder as Fg250, factor of safety as 5. Poisson ratio Poisson ratio as 0.25, then calculate the thickness of the cylinder wall. Calculate the thickness of cylinder wall and (clears throat) apparent as well as net stresses.
What is the value of reboring allowance?
Sorry?
What is the value of reboring allowance?
I'm just sharing with you. Wait. Don't worry, I'm just sharing with you. See, these are the values of reboring allowance C. For a diameter of 75 millimeters, the reboring allowance should be taken as 1.5. For 100, it should be taken as 2.4. For 150, it should be taken as 4. अभी अपना issue यह है कि अपना जो diameter है वो कितना है? 115 millimeter है. तो आपको याद होगा आप लोगों ने thermodynamics में steam table का use करते हुए आप लोगों ने एक इंटरमीडिएट वैल्यू का आपने इंटरपोलेशन से आपने वैल्यू मालूम किया था, पता है?
यस सर, यस
थर्मोडायनामिक्स में सेट सेमेस्टर में स्टीम टेबल. उसी प्रकार से आपको यहां पर भी 115 का जो वैल्यू है उसका आपको आंसर मालूम करना है. ठीक है, अभी ये एक्चुअली एक्सटेंसिव पूरा मतलब पूरा एग्जॉस्टिव कंटेंट नहीं दिया हुआ, इसीलिए आपको ये करना पड़ रहा है. अदरवाइज आपको डाटा बुक में पूरा एक एग्जॉस्टिव भी वैल्यू मिल सकता है. ठीक है, सो ये समझ में आया?
यस सर,
यस सर.
ओके, सो नाउ आई मस्ट यूज, देखते कैसा है. So, the reboring allowance should be taken as 2.4 plus 4 4 4 minus 2.4 over 150 minus 100 into 115 minus 100. देखो कितना आता है करके, देखो जरा. कितना आता है देखो जरा करके, ये मैं इंटरपोलेशन कर रहा हूं. आपको याद है कुछ? आपने टीडी ने किया था थर्मोडायनेमिक्स में स्टीम टेबल?
यस
सर.
ओके, वेरी गुड. तो इस प्रकार से हमको सी का वैल्यू मिला. अभी आई एम गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट reboarding alarms. Okay. So, I'm starting with this. I'm saying let P is the thickness of cylinder wall, which is given by Pmax times B divided by 2 times sigma C plus reboarding allowance C, okay, where I have sigma C given as sigma UT by FOS, which is 250 divided by 5, giving me 50 megapascal. Okay. Also, I have See, maximum gas pressure is not given directly, correct? Also, assuming Pmax as 10 times of P mean, which is coming out to be 10 into 0.35 from the previous question, this is going to give me 3.5, okay, megapascal. Substitute everything in this equation and you get, okay, and substitute and get P ka value here.
6.90.
Zero point?
6.90.
6.90. Okay, 6.90 can be approximated as 8 millimeters, for example.
Yes, 6.905.
Chalega, no problem. 8 millimeters.
The sigma C 59 megapascal.
Sorry, beta.
Sigma C.
Uh-huh.
50 megapascal, no?
Okay. Sorry. This is 50 megapascal. Sorry. After determining the thickness, you need to find out
apparent and net stresses.
Now we need to find out apparent stress. Apparent stress. Circumferential stress, sigma C is equal to Pmax T divided by 2T. Okay. So, substitute here, you're going to get 3.5 into 115 डिवाइडेड बाय 2 इनटू 8 कितना आता है देखो
25.156
सॉरी
25.156
इसमें व्हाट इज योर कमेंट अलाउबल वैल्यू ऑफ 50 दैट इज व्हाट डिजाइन इज सेज Okay, now number two, you have longitudinal stress. The longitudinal stress sigma L is given by Pmax times D square. Upon DO square minus D square. Right now, Vedant? Vedant Kadam?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So, how do you find DO? So, you have where, next line, where DO is equal to P plus 2 times T.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
How much is coming out to be?
131.
You can post your answer in the chat box also so that I am able to see who is writing what.
Eleven point seven six.
Right, Shabam. Now what next? Now find out net stress. Number one. Net circumferential stress, that is sigma c net, is coming out to be sigma c minus mu times sigma l. Please calculate.
How much is mu value?
Sigma, I'm going to take
0.25.
0.25. Anas Sheikh, what is answer?
Please
write in the 22.21. Very good. Now number two. net longitudinal stress sigma L is equal to sigma L minus mu times sigma C. Very good. 5.47. Janil, Salman, Ahmed.
Yes, sir. 5.471.
Very good. Everyone, please mute your mic. Lot of disturbance is coming. Everyone requested to please mute mic. Saibani, please mute your mic. Talha. Okay, everyone else is us. Okay, fine. Okay, guys. So, see, we could understand some fundamentals of cylinder liner design. We understand that there are dry liners, there are wet liners. Okay, and we understood the design procedure, like as to how to find the diameter, how to find the thickness, length of the stroke, total height of the cylinder, or total length of the cylinder. Then, how to find what is called as the apparent stress and the net stress. Then, a small portion is left, which is basically based on determining the thickness of cylinder head and determining the number of studs as well as the cross section. Now, I expect that after understanding this procedure, you should be in a position to first solve this aspect. So, based on the understanding that and also assuming that you have understood this part, I'll be giving you one or two questions by today evening. So, please solve, okay, and try to submit it as early as possible on the Google Classroom. On the Google Classroom. And I also expect that by this time, all of you have got Sabosiddhika domain ID, which is for example, Zafar Hashmi at the rate mhssc.ac.in, right? Or maybe like Vedan Kadam at the rate mhssc.ac.in. Have you got this email ID?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Next time, now, in fact, when I'm going to share my subject code, okay, you all are requested to sign in the Google Classroom with the given ID so that we have official interaction between you and me. Okay, and whatever record you are submitting in the form of submission, in the form of assessment and all, it will be all online and also it will be all visible to like to both of us, student as well as me. Okay, so I hope that next time when you log in, you should log in from your domain email ID. And next time onwards, instead of posting my link on WhatsApp, I'll be sending you the email. Okay, so before logging in the for the lecture, you need to check your email all the time. Okay. Now next topic for the discussion is design of piston. That this is the next component: design of piston, piston pin, and piston rings. Okay. So, what is the first thing come to your mind? Okay, what is piston? For example, Ahmed Dhakwala.
Yes, sir.
What is piston, according to you?
Sir, piston is used for compressing the gas.
Okay. He is saying piston is something for compressing the gas. Anybody else? Afan Khan? Afan Khan from Mira Road. Not available. Mohsin Bash.
Present, sir. Yes, sir.
What is piston according to you?
So it helps to compress the gas in the chamber.
Okay, very good.
Sir, then so it also seals the chamber.
Very good.
And so it
start
it
the might, start the sorry. Next. Sir,
इतना ही पता है सर.
Okay, very good. कोई बात नहीं. You know better. Sharp Dalvi.
Yes, sir.
What is piston? Any idea?
Sir, वो device है power produce.
It is a component, it is a device with the help of which, like when first of all, it basically compresses the air-cooled mixture, it compresses the gas, and when the combustion takes place, whatever force is produced, okay, because of the gas produced, it gets pushed down, so whatever linear motion it has, this linear motion gets converted into rotary motion of the crankshaft. In short, the piston is something which basically moves up and down from PVC to PVC, and it basically sucks as well as sweep out the gases, the burn gases. Okay, and also it seals. Okay, along with the piston rings, it helps in basically providing proper sealing so that while the piston is moving from PVC to TVC during compression stroke, the air-filled mixture or the gases are not leak out either to the crankcase or to the gases from oil sump. So the first thing come to my mind whenever I talk about the piston is this. Okay, a piston is basically a cylindrical shaped body which is going to be having a few grooves like this. Okay. And it is going to have a big hole like this. Okay, it is going to have a big hole, something like this. Okay, this is also going to have some grooves. Okay, and in the groove, it is going to accommodate this metallic pieces, which are called as piston rings. And in this big hole, it is going to basically have, it is going to receive this particular pin, cylindrical body, which is called as gudgeon pin or wrist pin or piston pin. And this pin will basically assemble the connecting rod with the piston. Okay, so this is basically a piston along with a gudgeon pin or along with the piston rings. This set together is called a piston ring. Otherwise, there are some classification. As you can see, some of the rings are called as oil scraper ring and some of the rings are called as compression ring. Okay. Now the point is, the ring which function as an oil scraper. What do I mean? The ring which is basically located in the bottom, and it basically helps in scraping down all the lubricating oil. You remember yesterday we discussed about the hatch pattern, where the oil is intentionally is retained. So from there, from that surface, in every cycle, this scraper ring will basically take down, okay, and it will scrap down all the oil to the oil sump. Whereas these two rings, they basically provide a compressed sealing. That is why they are called as basically compression ring. Okay, they help in maintaining the proper compression above the piston here. Okay. This is one. If you cut the piston, there you will find some inner feature. You can see, for example, this is the cylinder head. Okay, this is the shape of the combustion chamber, a particular design, a particular shape of the combustion chamber. This particular the shape is provided probably for the swirl action of the air fuel mixture. Below there, okay, right from this surface till the end, niche, this is called as the skirt of the piston, and this part, okay, is called as boss of the piston, whereas this piece is the gudgeon pin. In addition to having this thing, there will be a circular slot here at the end so that we can restrict the lateral movement of this gudgeon pin, okay, with the help of this clip, with the help of this locking device called a circlip. This is called a circlip. Okay, so this is called as circlip. In addition to that, compared to this piston, where you have three grooves to accommodate three piston rings, here you have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, there are 5 grooves. Because this is a high capacity piston, this is going to be used for diesel engine or for high capacity engine. Okay, it is going to have 2 oil scraper ring, 1 oil scraper ring here, another oil scraper ring here. Okay, whereas here at the top you are going to have all the 3 accommodating the compression ring. So one thumb rule is understood that, okay, the oil scraper ring will always be below the compression ring. उसका आइडिया क्या है, उसका फंडा क्या है कि ये जो ऊपर वाली जो 2 रिंग है, ये जो ऊपर वाली जो ये जो 3 रिंग है, दे विल प्रोवाइड बेटर सीलिंग, वेयर इज दिस 2 और दिस 1, दिस ऑयल स्क्रैपर रिंग इज गोइंग टू प्रोवाइड ओके द स्क्रैपिंग एक्शन. ओके, सो फर्दर इफ यू सी द नोमेनक्लेचर, द टॉप सरफेस of the piston is called as the head of the piston or crown of the piston. Okay, head of the piston. Then there are some grooves as can be seen here. Okay, depending upon, for example, here you can see some holes. ये एक identification है कि अगर आपको पहचानना है कि oil scraper ring कहाँ लगने वाली है, तो यहाँ पर normally hole provide किया जाता है. You can see here also, some holes are provided here. Can you see this? Abhi yahan par, I expect fuzzle shake. Fuzzle, please unmute your mic. Ye lagta hai. Irfan Sheikh, अरे भाई कुछ जवाब नहीं दे रहा कोई, क्या बात है?
हेलो सर, फाजिल शेख।
फाजिल शेख किधर भाई, कुछ किधर गया था?
सर नेटवर्क इशू सर।
अच्छा अच्छा नेटवर्क इशू, वाओ व्हाट अ ग्रेट एक्सक्यूज। ओके इरफान शेख, यू टेल मी व्हाई दिस होल इज प्रोवाइडेड हियर इन द क्वेश्चन। मोहित चूला वाला?
यस सर।
व्हाट इज योर आंसर
सर? इट इज फॉर आइडेंटिफिकेशन।
हां
सर, टू आइडेंटिफाई वेयर यू हैव टू प्लेस ऑयल स्क्रैपर रिंग्स।
नो, इन एडिशन टू आइडेंटिफाई, सी व्हाट विल हैपन व्हेन द ऑयल इज गोइंग टू बी स्क्रैप ना, व्हाट विल हैपन थ्रू दिस होल। देखो यहां पर दिखता है देयर आर सर्टेन सरेशंस, सो थ्रू दिस सरेशन oil will not fall along the piston wall, but it will also be going inside also, inside surface, taaki inside surface mein jaane ke baad jo andar ka jo surface hai wo bhi lubricate ho, and after lubricating the internal surface it will fall down into the oil sump. Okay, so these are dual purpose, understand?
Yes sir.
Next, so we have piston head, we have groove section. This is this portion from the first groove till the head is called as stop land. This is called as stop land. Okay, then this is the gudgeon pinhole or pinhole. Okay, then from, I mean, you see, first of all, I'm emphasizing here, this land, this portion is called as land. It's called as land. Guru ke niche wala, ye guru hai, aur ye land hai. Theek hai, that is why it is called as top land. Okay, then you have 1, 2, 3, okay, these lands. Then this portion, sorry?
Wapas bataiye, wapas.
Okay, groove. See what I was saying.
पहले सर रेज कर दीजिए, कंफ्यूज हो रहा है कहां पे माउस है।
See what I was saying. The first of all, this portion where the ring is going to be inserted is called as groove. This is another groove. Okay, this is one another groove. ठीक है, so the space between the two groove, for example ये groove और ये groove के बीच में जो portion, ये land है, this is called as land. This is called as land, and this is the first land before the commencement of that first groove. That is why this is called as top land. Okay, and this hole which I was talking about to Fazil and Moise, this hole is called as the drill hole for returning the oil to the sump. Okay, then the portion from the last groove till the end, this portion right from this part to this part is called as skirt. Okay, this is called as skirt. Okay, next is, if you look at the internal construction, depending upon the size of the engine, depending upon the capacity of the engine, sometime some ribs are provided. See, it is not uniform, this thickness is not uniform, it is provided some extra material. This is called as the reinforcing rib. Whereas if you look at here, see here, ड्रिल होल जो दिख रहा था, मैंने आपको विच आई टॉक अबाउट द ड्रिल होल, दिस ड्रिल होल इज ऑल्सो हैविंग सम चैनल हियर, सो दैट व्हेन द ऑयल इज गेटिंग स्क्रैप द ऑयल विल एंटर इन टू दिस गैलरी एंड आफ्टर लुब्रिकेटिंग द गर्जन पिन इट विल फॉल हियर, ओके हियर, एंड इट विल फॉल इन टू दिस ऑयल सम्प। Okay, then here on this part, you are going to fix a circlip. The circlip is basically the locking device. It is in order to prevent the lateral movement of the gudgeon pin here, because you are going to have the gudgeon pin here. Okay. Next, the same thing.
Sir.
Haji.
सर गैस एक्युमुलेटर ग्रूव है वहाँ पे, उसको एक्सप्लेन करेंगे प्लीज। वो ग्रूव काफी शैलो है दूसरे ग्रूव से, और बहुत सारे पिस्टन्स में ऐसा मैंने नोटिस भी नहीं किया है सर, तो
यस इट इज नॉट यस यस ओके दिस इज अ स्पेशल काइंड ऑफ अ फीचर। महाले इज अ कंपनी, ओके दे बेसिकली मैन्युफैक्चर दिस वेरिएंस टाइप। सो सी हियर यू आर गोइंग टू हैव द पिस्टन रिंग, here you are going to have a piston ring, and here you are going to have the piston ring. Okay, these two, the first ye wala and this one will be the compression ring. See here it is written, the first compression ring and the second compression ring. But this is a special chamber provided. Okay, here for some time the gas is going to be accumulated, the air and fuel mixture is going to be accumulated while it is moving up and down. Okay, but suddenly the movement, the replacement of the gas is so fast that this space is going to get replaced all the time by the fresh gas. Okay, so this is basically a gas accumulator chamber. Okay, it is a special kind of a piston. Okay, wherein you don't find, in fact, if you look at this part, like for example this one, you don't find any here. Okay, gas accumulator. In fact, if you look at this piston also, there you don't find any gas accumulator. Here you have only ring number 1, ring number 2, ring number 3. This 3 will be compression ring, and this 2 will be oil ring. Okay. So this is a special kind of a design of the piston, wherein the gas is going to be accumulated for some time.
Okay, sir.
So these are, I mean, this is another variant. If you look at the shape, see here, the combustion chamber is having different design. Here, the combustion, the head is almost flat. Okay. Then if you look at this particular part, okay, this particular portion here, this particular head of the piston is also acting as a combustion chamber. So depending upon whether it is for high capacity, low speed engine, whether it is for diesel engine or petrol engine, the shape of the top part of the piston keep changing. Okay, but as a thumb rule, okay, don't take it as a hard and fast, but as a thumb rule, normally for the petrol engine with the piston size varying around, around 65, 70, 80 millimeter, the shape of the head will be flat. Okay, for example, it will be something like this. See, these are the various shape. Okay, here you find the almost flat. Here it is having some groove with the cut provided here. All this cut will basically help in the swirling action. Then here it is the dome shape. Here it is also flat with the two concave shape. This is basically 40% flat with a small dome shape. So all these variants are available in the market depending upon what kind of combustion chamber is provided in the cylinder head and what kind of action you basically intend to provide. That is basically the, and in fact, Mahale is basically a very big company in the world who manufacture the different types of pistons. So this is basically the idea. And of course, I wanted to show here a conventional kind of piston with the 2-3 compression ring here, and you have one oil ring here. Mind you, there is no any hard and fast rule. See, I mean, for example, here you have only, to both the oil rings at the bottom. But the example which we saw here, you had one oil ring above the gudgeon pin and one below the gudgeon pin. So this way, different manufacturers, different designs, okay, are available. But the purpose is same for all. Okay, so anyway, with this, I want to stop here. but it's Friday today, and also there is a lecture at 2 o'clock. Okay, so I'm stopping here. Ahmed Dhakwala, thank you for reminding me. Okay. Please respond to attendance.